Hello everyone, welcome to our intercultural and flipped foreign language classroom. Here are Amy and Bri. Today, we'd like to introduce you to one of the best animated films of the 21st century, which also won an Academic Award for Animated Feature, named Spirited Away. Spirited Away, as we've all known, is directed by Hayao Miyazaki.He usually applies many fantasy elements depicting Japanese culture, mythology, and folktales in his stories. And Spirited Away is no exception. For this video, our focus will be on the religious aspect of Spirited Away, which is related to the main topic of the video, Shintoism. Spirited Away's original title in Japanese is Sen to Chiyo no Kami Kakushi,which literally means hiding in the spiritual world or hidden by the god. It is a concept in Japanese folklore to explain how ancient people mysteriously disappeared. Therefore, the film title Spirited Away actually refers to the story of Chihiro, who is spirited away, then entering the spiritual world. The film begins with a 10-year girl Chihiro and her parent who are on their way to a new homeBut get lost in the wood. Before entering the wood, the Chihiro family passes by a small wooden gate called Toli. Toli signifies the entrance to a shrine. Entering through a Toli indicates people are entering into a sacred realm of Kami. The word Kami means gods in Japanese. Therefore, when Chihiro family passes the Toli, it may represent they will enter the realm of gods in the later plot.Then, as Chihiro's parents are fighting the right direction to their new house, Chihiro notices this stone house called Kohola. It is a small Shinto shrine either discovered near the larger shrine or on the street side.
あの家みたいの何?石の祠、神様のお家よ。
Shrine refers to the houses made for gods and nature spirits. There are the places of worship and the homes of Kami.The outlook of the shrine represents the Kami's hierarchy and power. Those roadside shrines are supposed to house minor gods and guardian spirits, which are also named Dosonjin in Japanese. Another representation of Dosonjin is the roadside stone statue that Chihiro notices in the forest, and another one is in front of the tunnel.Dosonjin is the Shinto deity of roads and borders, who represent a protector of travelers. Dosonjin statues were often put at the boundary of a village or at crossroads to indicate the right direction. This metaphor highly plays symbolically marks the Chihiro's family movement from the known to the unknown.
Hi everyone, I am Brin.And now I will be introducing another aspect that you may not notice when you first watch the film, which is hierarchy. So as you can see in the film, the bathhouse is actually in the form that is similar to a pagoda. So as seen, pagodas are this multi-leveled structure and they are believed to unite and connect heaven and the earth.So in the film, the structure of the bathhouse presents the hierarchy of the characters. The higher the level, the closer they are to heaven. And so they will have better and cleaner rooms to use. So let us start from the very bottom, which is the underground floor. It is the boiler room where the Kamaji and the soot spirits live and work. They provide herbs and water to the customers. And as you can see, this place, the environment they work in is actually dark and hot. And it can only be accessed through this very, very steep stairs that Chihiro used. Now move on to the upper floor, which is the first floor called G. So in this floor, we welcome a great number of general customers. So which means that most of the peoplemost of the customers will take a bath in the G floor. So, as you can see, the river Kami, who was once dirty and stinky before taking a bath, was brought and actually bathed in the first floor. And move on to the next floor, which is Niten, Er Tin. So for customers like No Face, who appeared to be more lavish and rich and from an upper class because he tends to like give gold to the people working there. So for customers like him, he would be invited to the second heaven floor, Nitian, which is more private and they have more luxurious services. And then on the very top is Ten, which is Yubaba's office. So as you can see,her office is this very large, open spaced, and it has many luxurious decorations and ornaments in the whole office. So, as you have all just learned, there are still many differences between Japanese and Taiwanese cultures, even though there are all countries in Asia. So, learn to observe, compare, and to embrace the other culture is very, very important when you want to communicate with others.And of course, you need to also know well about your own culture.